Hi, I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on to your afternoon video cast. Let's take a look outside. This is kind of a cool picture. Getting one little sunny break in that low cloud cover. You see the sunshine there in the middle of the Mississippi River on our bridge camera, but for the most part, we're going to stay pretty much mostly cloudy to overcast. Now, as we get lucky later on in the day after the front passes, maybe we'll see a little bit of sunshine. Take a look at the satellite and radar imagery. Front draped across the area in a fashion like that. Trying to work some clearing skies in here, but we'll see. We'll start clearing at least overnight tonight into tomorrow. So your exact cast headlines, we've got a slow-moving cold front really taking its time moving through the area. We are going to be a little bit cooler and a little less humid. We'll take that. And the weekend, looks like we're going to be seeing a little bit of rain, maybe a lot of rain as well. I'll show you the forecast model in just one moment. Satellite and radar imagery, we've got a couple of upper-level features, low-pressure systems rotating around the larger area of low pressure. I'll show you that upper-level pattern in one moment. There's high pressure that's continuing to push this front through the area. In the lower levels, in the upper levels, notice we've got this big, what we call a long wave trough, extends into the Pacific Ocean, down into Mexico, and back across. And these areas of low pressure are rotating around it. It's this area of low pressure right now making its way near the Chicagoland area that's pushing that front through. The question is, over the weekend, as far as the rainfall goes, where does the bottom of this trough land as it continues tracking toward the east? If it digs a little farther south into the Gulf of Mexico, we'll see less rain. If it stays across the area, we'll see more rain. But all the cold air, unfortunately, I know a lot of people want to see or feel some of that cold air. It's going to track more toward the east, not so much digging southward. So we'll get a little bit of cold air, but not a whole lot. All right, here's a forecast model. There's our front as it pushes through, holding on to a 30% chance of rain. For your Thursday, as we get into the overnight hours tonight through tomorrow morning, our front transitions over into a warm front. Tomorrow morning, a little bit of cloud cover. As we get to tomorrow afternoon, not seeing a whole bunch of rain. It's a little bit later in the day. We'll hold on to about a 20% chance of rain. And then in the overnight hours, Friday into Saturday, that warm front starts to overspread the region. At the same time, winds are going to be ramping up from the west northwest. You see some bullseyes developing here right off the coast. And by 7 o'clock on Saturday morning, potentially, we're going to get some pretty heavy weather here. Not necessarily any thunderstorm activity. We could see a few isolated thunderstorms, but mainly some moderate to heavy rainfall will be possible. And this is a second cold front now. Eventually, we'll push through Saturday by 6 p.m. We'll have a little bit of cloud cover. And I'm expecting Sunday to be a bit more on the clear side. For today, upper 70s, lower 80s, 30% chance of rain. Mostly cloudy. Then overnight tonight, some clearing skies, feeling a little less muggy. Temperatures in the 60s for the most part. Couple of spots on the North Shore could be dipping into the upper 50s. And your 7-day exact cast. Going to keep your rain chances at 40% just because of a little uncertainty. If the model verifies, that'll be about 60% chance. And then we keep things clear on Sunday. Mid 70s, that's that little cool off I was talking about. Temperatures 50s and 60s as we get to Sunday morning. And then another upper level feature will bring another round of rain heading into next Monday and Tuesday. I'm Exact Weather meteorologist Jay Galley, and thanks for logging on.